Communism, the cold, hard truth. Kim Il-sung, North Korea. Fidel Castro, Cuba. Mao Zedong, China. And Joseph Stalin, the USSR. Through these leaders, communism is spreading. This special edition of 5050 is brought to you by Vault-Tec, revolutionizing safety for an uncertain future.
Hello, my name is Nicholas Grisak, and today we're going to talk about the threat of communism. Every day, America fights for freedom and democracy by stopping the communist forces that would seek to destroy democracy worldwide. Already, two countries, Greece and Turkey, desperately try to hold on to their freedom by pleading for America's help. And through the Truman Doctrine, we can give them just that. Without our help, both countries may be looking at famine and communist takeover because of the weak political conditions of their countries. The entire Greek culture is at threat due to the sheer nature of communism, and the UN can do nothing about it. With America being Greece's only hope to retain a stable government, now more than ever, the Truman Doctrine proves its merits. If Greece falls, Turkey is sure to follow. The Middle East will not be far behind, and soon after, communism will spread throughout the world. The Truman Doctrine is an investment in peace to protect countries against the totalitarian rule of communism and push back the threatening existence of communism. The Truman Doctrine is proving to be a successful and reasonable response to the threat of communism in Greece and Turkey, and is pushing Soviet forces out of countries they do not belong in, and eliminating the threat of communism along the way. We'll be right back after a word from our sponsors. We're back, talking about the McCarran Internal Security Act and how it safeguards the American way of life. U.S. officials discovered that 70% of the communist movement's leaders are not American-born citizens. These communists seek to destroy our way of life and eliminate democracy. The McCarran Internal Security Act protects true Americans from communist movements by exposing the communist traitors and stopping their anti-American plans. It does this by requiring communist organizations to register with the government, and it gives the government the ability to deport foreign-born citizens involved in these communist organizations. Well, folks, that's all the time we have for today. Check back in next week, where we'll be talking about Soviet Russia and nuclear weapons. Are they ready to nuke, or are they just Stalin?